on page. Okay, yeah. This is the formula. Yeah. Okay. If whenever leverage larger than this formula, n is the number of relations, p is the number of independent variables. For example, in this case, how many data we have? 10. So this is how many independent variables we have? 2. So if any leverage larger than 0.90, no. So it's fine. We don't have any inferential data. Okay, but sometimes they have a problem. Okay, here, in this case. Now, A. One independent variable. So this will be becomes so 0.75. Here we found one relation, this one, the last one. The leverage becomes larger than this formula. So this data, you shouldn't be concerned this data as a okay, potential problem causing the but in some case, the data, okay, this is the X, this is the Y, this is a regression, and they say if the this data is not included, then you will get the regression like this one. But if you include this data, your regression will get this one. And it seems these two are not big difference between these two regression lines. So this formula is not, you are not sure you will detect. This is not good criteria, okay, to detect any potential problem causing by outlier. So if you, based on the criteria of this formula, you say, oh, this leverage of this, the last data, because this, the leverage of this one, HI is 0.90, is greater than this formula, but actually it's not so bad. If you include this data, okay, this data is this one, 1539. Actually, this is in the same direction. So if you include this outlier, the result is not so bad. If you delete this data, the result will become this one. So actually, leverage is not good idea. So that's why they ask, you need to check the cook. You need to check cook. The textbook say if any observation, the cook value is greater than one, you can delete that. Okay. And I will show you how to just get these two values. Consumer, okay, case problem. Case problem, consumer. This one. family income. I'm surprised the family income is not big. Even I'm in Taiwan, make more money than American people do. $65,000, not much. The maximum annual income I made is more than $100,000. I can easily make. Don't you know how much money you can save in the United States if you find a job? If you have this family income, how much money can you save per year? Do you have any idea how much money you can save? You need to deduct your tax. Tax is 30%. If you are single, 40%. Okay? Can you save your money? You know, how about in Canada? More than 40%. You can make 200,000 Canadian. 200,000 Canadian, but how much money you can make? You can save only 100 Canadian. Because the tax is over 50%. How many population in Canada? It's a good idea to live in Canada. The country is much bigger than the United States. But there are 300 million people, only 30 million people. And you need to pay the tax for all highway. If you go to Canada, the highway is condition of the highway is terrible. No highway because in the United States, there are so many highways because they are 10 times larger than population in Canada. And people pay all the high tax. How many aircraft carrier in the United States? Well, there are 300 million people pay. But in Canada, only 30 million people. Only two highways. You know, they cannot afford. So that's why every people need to pay tax more than 40% in Canada. So do you think it's a good idea to live in Canada? And every grocery in the Canada is more probably 1.3 times higher than United States because everything is imported from United States because not many companies. Everything buy from the United States. So let's know you can save money. Okay, even in the United States, can you save money? I asked so many people, okay, my classmates, okay, how much money they can save per year? I can easily save more than $300,000 every year in Taiwan. Even my salary, if I'm a professor in the United States, I can easily make $200,000. If you are a dean of the business school, your salary is. Is that possible for you to save more than 30,000? Sure. If you take the 30%, how much money actually you got? 30%. So you take one third divided by one third. You take 80,000. So actually you got probably just. If you have so much money, you know how much money the president of University of Houston, she is an Indian. Go to the website, check the University of Houston. She came from India, only 52 years old. How much money she make per year? 1.2 million. That's a lot of money. She go to United States. To be the professor, to become the president of university.
It's too difficult for us to go to exchange because of visa policy.
If you make so much money, 1.2 million, how much tax you need to pay? One third. So you only got $800,000. What kind of house are you going to buy? For this amount of money, you will buy probably 8 million house. How much mortgage you need to pay? So don't buy very expensive house. Because the property tax in the United States is 3%. So that's why even you make more money, there's no way you can save money because you spend all the money. You should look like a Chinese people. We live very simple life. We don't spend money. I can save 90% of my income. 90%. Okay, easy, because I don't spend any money. Except the grocery. So save your money, okay? So we are, I'm so good in number. I'm so good in number. You can study any number with me.
American dream.
Okay. If you ask the American people how much money do you have in the saving account? Saving account in your bank. Not many people, their saving is more than $10,000. Most people, they don't have money in the bank. Okay, this is the income. This is the, how many people you have? Household size. Okay, this is the how much money you spend for your credit card. So this is a Y, this is X1, this is X2. Okay. Before you run a regression, run a correlation between these variables. Okay, you can see the Y is here. So the correlation between X1 and the Y is 0.631. For household is 0.753. The correlation between X1 and X2 is very low. So the correlation between independent variables is less than 0.7, you don't need to worry about the convenient problem. Okay. So run a program, regression. Why? X1 and X2. And this is convenient check, diagnostic. Okay. We will use enter first. And, okay. You need to plot the residual. Always plot the Y, the dependent variable. And the student delete residual, okay. Check if there's any outlier. And the save it. Okay, here. We don't need to save and standardize residual. It's useless. The standardized is not so, okay, delete this one or this one. Okay, this one. Okay, here. This cook is here, and the debris is here. You don't do it by calculation, do it by software. So everything is here. Check the output. Wow, there is outlier. Who are they? There are two. So don't look at the output of your R-square, okay, and the F-test, the T-test, okay. The result is not good, so we are going to check which one. Okay, we have a outlier. Something. Actually, you should delete this one. And we have a outlier on this. This one you need, because this is more than 3, you need to delete this. So I delete 2 outliers here. Okay, we still have a. At the beginning, we have 50 observations. Now we have a. Okay. And so actually we don't first check your residual first, okay, and check it away, do it again. Regression, everything will be the same. Check the outlier. Okay, one more here. Which one is this? Positive, so I should use this one. Take this away. So now we have a 43 sample. We delete 2 more. So don't look at your output unless you solve the problem about the outlier. Do it again. Epstein. Yeah, Epstein is open now. Epstein is open. And you can see your decision. The standard decision. Descending, it's okay. Descending, it's okay. And how about Cook? Is anything is larger than one? Descending, descending. No, it's okay. How about leverage? Based on this formula, HI greater than, in this case, we have 47 observation depth, and we have two independent variables. So this is is only 0.14. It's okay. But Cook is more important. Okay, Cook. No, any value of Cook is larger than 1. So we are done. And then you can read the output. Go to the output, the R square. Wow, great. 90%. And the t test. Okay, standardized. So income, the household is more important because correlation, income has the highest correlation with the Y. Then and the household is has a higher correlation than income does. So the t-test, this is the standard coefficient is bigger than this one, which makes sense. And there's no continuity problem between these two variables. Good, okay. This is the end of chapter 15. Chapter 16. Okay, 16.1234, and I will talk about autocorrelation, and Durbin Watson test. The model can be, we remember X1, how come this is a Z or D? Because we call this is X1, the simple first order, okay. Is one independent variable. We call predict variable means independent variable. This is x1 and s1 squared, second order with one. So the z1 will be equal x1. Z2 will be become x1 squared. So it can become like this one. Z, okay. Let me z1 here. Okay, z1, z2. Z1 equal x1, z2 means x1 square. Okay. You can be, for if there are two independent variables, x1, x2, you can be second order with two predicted variables. It can be x1, x2, x1 square, x2 square, and the interaction. The paper I'm going to present next week for those PhD students, don't confuse about the interaction. How do you check interaction? How would you check interaction? Who is going to present the interaction? In the paper, they talk about interaction. Who are you?
My study is about t-test.
Only t-test?
Yeah.
If you read the paper, okay, this is X1. This is X2. This is why. This is we call moderate. So why? Okay, just why, not about you. Yes, that means you have a light, okay. If you don't have this light, then you don't have this term, okay. And now you can see, they used to use, actually this is big X. X1, X2, X3. So X1 will be the average of these three. And this is the big X2. So X4, X5, X6. 10 years ago, people get the average of X2. You get the average. For example, if you got a 2.2. And the lowest sample, lower than 4.2, the mean, okay, mean. They call low. The other one is larger than 4.2, the mean, they call high. So they separate two lines. Okay, one is for a low, the other one for H. So you have two regression. Now, if you do this way, okay, if you submit your paper to any journal, most journal editor will reject your paper. You cannot allow to do that. So what are you going to do? So the moderate, how are you going to do? What? So you still use the average of these three, okay? For this one, it's very complicated. X1 multiplied by X4 cross X1 multiplied by X5 cross X1 multiplied by X6 cross X2 multiplied by X4. How many terms? Total there are 3 times 3 because there are 3. There are 3. So total there are 9 terms. Okay? You add them together, check the hypothesis. Where theta 3 equals 0, they check the moderate by looking at the interaction of this term. 3 times 3 is 9. Plus, okay, but fun, okay. How are you going to use the software to solve the problem? Okay, go ahead, do your research. And your model won't look like this simple. Your model can be very complicated. Okay, interaction. Yeah, how many interactions we have? 9. Interaction, okay. So whenever we talk about moderator, we are dealing with interaction between not just X1 and X2. You can see there are 9 items. 9 terms. Okay. This is simple statistic. This is more complicated in the real world for research. Okay. Oh, sometimes you have a log transformation, you need to do the so your model can be like this one. Wow, what's going on? X and Y, not the linear, but it's non-linear explanation model. What are you going to do? How do you know the relation between X and Y is this form? X, okay, if you take log, the not common law, so nature law, for force. So you will get a white front. White front will be equal law, nature law. So this will become cross. So you will become beta front cross beta 1 x front of this detector log. So this will become linear. From non-linear to linear. Okay. I don't have real data for you for this case. This is very complicated. If you have four models, every term sum square will be smaller. Okay. If you have a reduced model, the sum square will be bigger. Okay. So this idea is, I can give you an example. This one. Okay. This is just the ID number. This is how much? How long did you need to visit your customer? This is how much time you need to spend? This is actually this is Y, and this is X1. This is the Y X2, and how many customers you need to visit? Actually, this is the. This is integer, scale, and this is one. Okay. So you run the program. Convenient. This three. You can see the y, the kilometer x1 is a higher correlation between x and the y. X1, x2. And Y is much lower. And the correlation between these two independent variables is very low. So there is no convenient problem. Okay, so if you run the program first, run the regression, okay, the Y is this one, this is X. Actually, you need to plot the residual, but I'm not going to do this because I won't waste my time. Talk about residual. We already talked too much about the residual on chapter 14 and 15. Now I'm going to focus on. Okay. Now R square here. You see? If I go on you, X1, okay. The residual is, for error term is. 8.029. Okay, remember the total. The sum square. Okay, if I put X2 in the model, what will happen? Well, the sum square for error term will increase or decrease if there are one more independent variable. The R square now is 66.4%. If I run the full model, if I put 2x2 in the model, You see? The total sum squared doesn't change. The same. But regression from 15 become 21. So R squared become much bigger because residual become smaller. This one become 2.299. So the this one become 21. The total is the same. The total is the same. It's always the same. So this increase, this decrease. So this decrease. So the question is, do we need to put add one more variable in the model? So the formula is this one. Reduce means for the first time we have only x1 in the model minus we put 4 model, that means we include x2 in the model and we divide by how many independent variables we increase 1 because from 2 to 1 and divided by the 4 model and divided by the degree of freedom, I always say n minus p plus 1, the error term. Okay. This. So, this will be equal to minus 2.299 divided by 1 divided by the full model 2.2 and the sample will be in this case 10 minus 2 plus 1. Okay, so if this value larger than the table value, the numerator degree of freedom is 1, the denominator degree of freedom is n minus p plus 1, then you reject null hypothesis. So you can extend to the internal case, okay? But in the real world, we don't care. We just want all independent variables. We don't need to do this. Whether we are going to add or delete one variable.